Hey designers, if you are using Articulate Rise to develop your courses, you need to watch this video. It's really important, not only for those with disabilities, that you include accessibility features, but if you include those features, you're going to make your Rise course easier to use for absolutely everyone. So stay tuned to find out really quickly how to make your Rise courses accessible. I'm Lindsay, and I cover instructional design, e-learning development, and all things online teaching and learning. So I love Articulate Rise. I love Storyline too, but I love Rise possibly more these days because while your creativity is more limited than your creativity is limited with Storyline, which is basically sky is the limit, Rise courses are responsive, they're more easily updated, and they are much easier to make accessible. Storyline can be made accessible too. I've got another video on that. But Rise is just quicker and easier all around, including for making it accessible. One of the really nice things is that when you build courses in Rise, you use the blocks. Most of the blocks in Rise are already accessible. I've got a handout that I provided in the show notes below that gives more information on how to know which blocks are accessible and which ones are not and what to do if one's maybe semi-accessible. So check that out. But what's really nice is that when you use the blocks that are accessible, you don't have to worry about the hierarchy of content like you do when you use Microsoft Word or Microsoft PowerPoint or again Storyline. You don't have to worry about headings, you don't have to worry about any of those things. You just lay out the content in the block as the block intends and you're basically good to go. The ultimate result is going to be really easy keyboard navigation, solid alt text, captions in all your videos. These are the basic things that I'll show you how to do in Rise. If you want to go more in depth, reach out. I can coach you through it through my side business, Lindsay O Consulting. So let's take a look at a course that I've already published and it's already made accessible. So this is a Rise course that was published for the web. I'm hosting it on my Google Cloud Storage account. I'm going to keep my hands off the mouse. I'm only going to use my keyboard to navigate so you can see what this experience is like for those that use the keyboard. All right, so basically your goal whenever you're creating a course that's accessible is to make sure first that it's keyboard navigable. So using the tab key, which is different from some other software, but for Rise and Storyline courses, you use the tab key. You can see that I'm hitting tab and I'm able to browse through the menu here. If you hold shift and tab, you can pop back up, hit the return or enter button to dive into one of these lessons and start learning. So again, I can use the tab button here. You can see the skip to lesson appears at the top, so you can skip through the menu here. If you just keep on going, you can browse through the menu on the left to jump to another lesson, or you can dive into the lesson at hand. Now, everything in your Rise course is usable with a keyboard, including videos. Spacebar to play the videos.
Drinking water is just the start to preventing.
If you want to adjust the video options, you hit that tab key, go through, you can see each of those items is highlighted, so on and so forth. You can move through tab interactions with your tab key to select the tab interaction and then the arrow keys to go back and forth. That's my left and right key I'm using here. And you can make things larger. Hit that continue button, so on and so forth. It lets you browse through all the content here. So how you can do this is actually pretty easy. There's just a few key things you need to keep in mind. So this is the editing version of this particular Rise course. If we go into edit content, I'll show you how this works. So if you're familiar with Rise, which I assume you are if you're watching this video, you know you can add blocks. I've already got some blocks built out here. Now I've already got this video in here, but I need to add captions. Okay. At this moment in time, Rise does not caption your content for you. I know they are building more AI features to come and that might change, but right now you do need to add your own subtitles. And even if AI captioned this, you would need to make sure those captions were correct. So once you add in the video, you have to go back, hit edit, manage captions. First thing you need to do is enter the language in which the captions will be presented. I'm using standard English, and you have to upload the captions file. Now, note that Rise uses VTT captions, not SRT, which is subrip. If you are using Storyline, That is different. But for Rise, you got to use VTT captions. So if you are creating your captions on, say, YouTube, those get published in SRT, and you can just go to the internet, search SRT to VTT converter. There's some free converters out there, and they'll convert it to VTT for you. So it has to be in VTT, or Rise won't recognize it. I've already converted this one. And that's it. I've added the captions. I'm good to go. I can download this again if I need to. I can delete them. I can add something else, but I'm good to go. And you can test this out in edit mode. So hit play. I'll turn off the sound here, turn the captions on. There they are. Those are my captions for the voiceover for this video. They are very easy to read, and users will be able to experience those. Next up, again, this block is accessible. This is a nice list block. Rise or Articulate does offer a list of blocks are accessible and not. I'll show you how to add an image and add alt text. So when you add an image block in Rise, it gives you this default image. If you want to edit this content, I'm going to edit this and replace it from the content library. I'm going to look for a fan to illustrate my course here. I love this one. This fan looks great. So again, just like with the video, you upload the video and then you have to go back and add the alt text. It's not obvious how to add the alt text here. It's not the caption, though adding a caption is great. I'm going to hit edit again, and then you can edit the alt tag here. If something's decorative, you don't have to do anything, just leave it blank. Otherwise, you need to type in the alt text if it adds any sort of meaning to your content. So I'll leave it like that, a nice cool fan. You can add a caption as well if you want to. So that adds just the alt text. You can see there's nothing on the image here. If you add a caption, that'll appear on it as well. There we go. Okay, then that caption comes up below. And you can also do text on image if you want to. I know that's one of the features in Rise. And if you do that, you gotta make sure there's enough contrast between the text and the image below. Rise isn't going to check that for you, and sometimes the image can be so busy that that text will not present well and be readable on top of that image. So those are actually the basics of making your courses accessible in Rise. Automatically, Rise will produce courses that are keyboard navigable. You just have to add captions, you have to add alt text, and you have to make sure you're avoiding those text blocks that are not accessible. So again, I've got a handout for you down in the show notes. It's got a link to this page. It's updated as of February 2024. The stuff does change, so keep an eye out for that. You can see the current inaccessible ones. Avoid those because they're not accessible at all. Most of the accessible blocks give you some instructions on how to make it accessible. For instance, an audio block, there's no captions yet possible for audio files in Rise. So you could turn that audio maybe into like a video with just like a static image and put captions on it. Or you could use the caption field to provide text for that audio. And there's no audio description yet for videos as well. This stuff is going to change, but right now this is what it is, and these are the workarounds for it. And you don't need to include audio descriptions necessarily, depending on what level of accessibility you're aiming for, whether it's WCAG 2.0 level 8A, I believe is a standard for Section 508. Level 8AA, you would need to include an audio description, but for basic Section 508 compliance, you don't have to. If you know your audience, you know you have people with disabilities, maybe that's something you need to do, but think about where you're at and what you're able to do. It's nice to include, but think about whether you must include it or not. More accessible is always better, of course. And then down at the bottom, we have the fully accessible text block. So these are all the ones that you don't have to worry about at all. They are fully accessible, including these interactives here as well, which is nice. So this list of fully accessible gets longer every year. Articulate's doing a great job of making its content, its software more and more accessible and adding more and more features. I think it's going to get even better when they build AI into Rise and Storyline finally. So I can't wait for that to happen. All right, what do you think? Did I miss anything? Be sure to check out that handout in the description below the video, and I would love to hear what your challenges are and how I can help you out.